Now, our friends in Europe started to feel it. When things get tough, people start looking around for funds and money and what's going on. And they discovered in Britain 2 months ago that big multinational companies operating in Britain actually are not paying taxes. And there was a case, I think we all see, of company like Starbucks. Huge profits. Well, I didn't say profits because they claim don't have a profit. Huge revenue. No taxes. Even Amazon, Google, all these big names. Billions of dollars of business every year in the UK, and they don't pay tax. One of them paid £10 million, just to be fair, they paid something. And of course, why? What is going to happen here? And again, is this mispricing IPR, you know, our logo, our whatever, we charge for that? So all this accountancy based theft really need to be brought up. And what happened is, you know, the public start to react to this. So the chief executive of Starbucks ran to UK and say, okay, I'm going to make a gift to the inland revenue, here's a check for £20 million. And you say, look, we're not looking for gifts. Just pay your tax properly. Do your books properly. That's all what you're asking for in a fair and a proper manner. This issue is starting now to gain momentum in Europe, in France, in Germany, because people start to realize that there is something wrong here. There are trillions of dollars sitting on all this exotic tax haven. Trillion. You know, trillion, I'm not saying billion, trillions of dollars. If you translate that in Polo, you're going to need a whole this big to write numbers. And it's sitting there. It's just to avoidance of tax, and they cannot take it back to US because it's going to tax, you cannot put it here, you cannot adjust money sitting there. When the whole economy in Europe and the United States is crying for jobs and investment, etc. So it started to help back the countries of all these companies. So that this is an issue which we, I'm very delighted that Cameron and the next G8 meeting, first time we started to look at this issue, and this is from Swell Fund, and they have to do something about it. But this issue is hurting us in Africa, and we need to deal with it. That's something really